Hey guys, today we're going to be changing out pads and rotors. Now, as much as possible, you want to work on a level surface, but regardless, you always want to secure the wheels. Also, make sure the vehicle is in park or in gear and apply the parking brake. Now, before we work on the vehicle, we have to put the vehicle up in the air. There's a center point here where we can jack it up, and then we're using the frame rails to hold our jack stands. We're also putting cardboard underneath each of the rotors to help collect any debris so it doesn't get on the driveway.
After removing the wheel, you're going to want to remove the guide pins. Most jobs, you're only going to be replacing the pads and the rotors, and you do not need to disconnect the caliper unless you're replacing them or you're doing some sort of rebuild. In order not to damage the brake lines, we're going to secure it with a bungee cord.
Next, we have to release the bolts that are holding on our caliper bracket. With the bracket off, we can now remove our rotor. With everything apart, you want to take brake clean. We're just using the CRC stuff and clean the surface. Take your time here, and what you really want to focus on is around the studs. Because if this area here is uneven, our rotor will not mount evenly, and then we're going to get poor pad distribution onto it, and that's where you're going to get that warp feeling. So there's a tool you can actually get that's a wire brush that'll go right around here, and that's going to do a really good job of cleaning off all the corrosion. However, you want to get all of this as even as possible as well. You can't neglect any of the hub. You see here why we put the cardboard down. All our debris is getting on here, and this way we keep our driveway clean. So we're making sure we're getting rid of all the rust scales. So you can see over here, if we just put the rotor on and we have a bunch of this on here, it's just not going to mount properly. So what we're doing right now is we are putting on brake lube. This is specifically for brakes. See right here, we're not using anti-seize because that tends to gum up. We're going to also use it on our guide pins as well. And then what we're going to do is we're going to use our finger to thin it out. We don't want this globbing up underneath the rotor. So these rotors had acceptable thickness, so we just had them turned. Like I said, we're going to be doing a big brake kit on this vehicle anyways, but we need to do something so we have a safe vehicle. So even though these have been turned, you can see that there's a bunch of debris on there. We have to go ahead and clean it with brake clean. So we want to make sure that we do this on both sides. Now, if you guys are ever dealing with new rotors, you're going to have to do the exact same thing because they put a coating on there to prevent corrosion. After cleaning the rotor, we can go ahead and put it on. We're wearing clean gloves again because we want to make sure that we don't touch the mating surface with contaminated gloves. Now, when it comes to your brake hardware, if you can purchase new brake hardware, go ahead and do that. Ours is still in good condition, and what we're doing is we're adding brake lube before we install the pads. We're also adding lubricant to the back of our new pads. We're also going to inspect our dust boots here for the guide pins. If these are cracked or if they're worn out in any shape or form, just buy a new hardware kit. It's so cheap, it's not worth skimping out on parts like this. We now have our bracket in and our pads installed, so we know everything works. Now what we do is we usually compare the old pad to the new one to make sure it's going to be the right part. Now we can go ahead and compress the caliper. Now to compress the piston, there are different tools you can use. You could use a C-clamp, but we actually like using this. This is designed specifically for brake calipers. Now what I like about this is really great for fixed calipers, but it'll work on a floating piston just as well. Now here's a quick tip. So when we are going to compress it, you could just compress the piston in the caliper and then you could fit it over the new pads because the new pads are a lot thicker. However, these calipers get really hot and there's going to be a lot of acid in here. So what we have to do is we're going to crack it open first. And now we can go ahead and start compressing the pushing the pistons back in. And what we're trying to do is we're trying to push the fluid out of the caliper before it makes its way back to the ABS module. So you see all this stuff. So we're just pushing the piston, and it's pushing all the nasty stuff out. That way it doesn't go back up to our ABS module. We also want to make sure that our calipers are clean. Now, whether brand new or used, make sure to always re-grease your guide pins. Okay, we go ahead with the guide pins in. We have to make sure everything's aligned and make sure that we don't misalign the boot. Thread it in by hand. And once we have everything snug, we'll torque it down afterwards. Now make sure you check your service manual to know what the torque specs are for tightening up everything. After you've installed everything, you may or may not have to do some sort of break-in procedure. So we're using these stop tech pads, and you can see here it says no break-in required. I would still recommend that when you install new brakes, whenever, is just to be very easy. You know, brake really lightly, brake really early, just to help them bed in a bit better. Whenever dealing this, we always have to make sure we check the brake fluid afterwards. It is recommended that you do a full bleed. Even taking out the fluid out of the calipers, we have to top it off a little bit. For brake fluid, we're using Motul's 5.1. The reason being is this vehicle sees a lot of mountain driving and it sees a little bit of track use, so we get it really hot. If you don't know what to use, make sure you use something that's .3 or .4 compatible, and also double check your service manual to see what the manufacturer recommends. Now, once you have everything put back together and you're not touching the brakes anymore, hit it again one more time with brake clean. As you can see here, our fingers touch the disc surface and we have a little bit of lubricant on there. So we want to make sure the entire surface is clean before we drive the vehicle. Now, before we go ahead and test this on the street, we want to make sure that we have the engine running and we pump the pedal a few times on the brake. You always want to make sure you have pressure. You don't want to just put your brakes together and start driving, because you might not have enough pressure to do a proper brake application. With everything done, we just have to finalize and torque the wheels. It's highly recommend you always torque your wheels, especially on brakes, because you want to apply even pressure to the rotor. Now that we have everything back together and we're ready to go for a test drive, what we're going to do is we're going to go really easy on the brakes, and for the first few hundred kilometers, we're going to brake early and be really light on that brake pedal to help with the braking procedure.
Well, there you guys have it. That's how you change out rotors and pads with a floating caliper setup.